So, people in the room, most of you have probably played with Xtrabackup or know about it.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So this, you haven't. So there are many ways in MySQL to do backups. Traditionally, you can do MySQL dump, which creates you an SQL file, or you can just copy the directory. If you stop the server and copy the MySQL directory, and there are some other ways. And then there used to be this tool, or there still is the tool, InnoDB Hot Backup, which is now called MySQL Enterprise Backup, which reads the InnoDB table space and redo log files in an online manner. So without you don't have to stop the server, and even if there are updates on the server, it will still kind of record also the updates, and you get a consistent backup in an online manner without blocking the running database. Xtrabackup is a tool developed by Pat Kona, and actually includes, so InnoDB Hot Backup had a kind of Perl script that you use as a utility around the actual backup tool. So this happened to be GPL, and Pat Kona has reused it. They don't like it, so maybe one day they will rewrite some, to something better.
Can
and I also,
can I intend to be implemented the extra backup binary itself? They're already making it.
Yeah, I think they are working on that. But basically, there are like two parts of the kind of online backup functionality. Just the first InnoDB tables, but then to take actual usable backup, you want to have a MySQL, MyASM tables,
yeah,
and all kinds of other information, which is currently done by this external script. And then even in the extra backup binary, I think they reuse a lot of InnoDB code. So it's GPL?
Yeah, in fact, they actually start a InnoDB.
Yeah,
there's like a stealth MySQL InnoDB started, ExtraDB actually.
But I suppose they do, it's maybe like a read-only thing or something, because they read the data files while the actual MySQL server is running. So it's still, it's not just like running another MySQL server, because you can't have two MySQL servers on the same day.
Right, it doesn't run it against the same IB log file and everything, but it reads the IB log file. Anyway,
yeah, I think it's basically like InnoDB, but read-only. Okay, but all of this is done about Pacona, and I'm not going to talk about it much, but it just changes the backup landscape in that now we finally have an open source tool, which we believe is the kind of perfect way to do backups. You get online backups, and then you don't have to do any tricks with like LVM disks or something like many people do with the file system level instead of data extraction. Okay, so then the next problem is that extra backup is a command line tool. So in practice, you then want to create some scripts or something to automate your backup so that they are run from cron or somewhere all the time, and where should the backups be copied, how often do you do incremental backups, or do you always do full backups. So all of this I was working on at work, and then I realized that actually Lahtan Mulkahi, I don't know how he actually pronounces his name, this is the problem. This is a general problem in the open source community. You just know people's email address, but you don't want to talk with them. So he also, for his own needs, the company he works at created this kind of manager utility. This is very new. I think he published it 2 months ago. It has no user interface. So I created an enhancement. So the first, when I started looking at it, it has parts of code that actually work. But to get anything to work, you have to insert SQL statements yourself into the configuration statement. Configuration tables. So I created a utility, like a configuration tool, which dumped the MySQL tables into CSV files, so that somebody could use maybe a spreadsheet or something, and then you type in your server domain names and when you want them to be backed up and when you want them to, where you want the backup to be saved. But and then you load this back into MySQL. So this is kind of a user interface nowadays. At the MySQL conference, we actually had a booth where somebody promised to then develop a web-based user interface. So we will see when that happens. But apart from being incomplete, I reviewed a lot of the code and I did some small stuff together with Lachlan. I think this is a promising project. I think it's kind of the approach that it's trying to take is sound. The code quality is okay. Like the code that exists is relatively free from bugs, actually. So it's just the features are missing. It's written in PHP, which I thought was funny. But then, again, at the MySQL conference, I realized that many of these LAMP shops actually write a lot of system utilities in PHP because they write everything else in PHP. And you can do that. So PHP has all of the kind of POSIX kind of functions that you would need, that you have in Perl and Python also. So it's a bit odd, but it's perfectly fine to do this kind of utility in PHP. And of course, in the sense that you eventually want to have some web-based user interface, it actually makes sense to write it in PHP. Because then you can reuse all the classes. So it uses a lot of object-oriented PHP code, and that makes the code quite nice. Okay, so this is the Google code page. Here is the blog. So Lachlan is posting occasionally his blog on the advances of this project, and that's currently the best place to follow this if you are interested. Okay, let's look a little bit what it looks like inside. I think I now have, because I just to kind of get more familiar with this, I have played a little bit with the codes. I think I now have two versions, neither of which quite will work. Let's go back at this to clean state. How do I have something like a revert? How do I go back? This is the bazaar.
The revert is there.
Why doesn't it do it?
Try help SVN revert. You need more arguments.
Okay. All right, get into work.
Check it out.
Well, anyway, if I check it out, it's still not configured to do anything on my, because it has like Lachlan's directory names and passwords. So I will not bother. So what we have here, anyway, I will just kind of talk you through what it's doing and what it's hopefully doing in the future. So I think kind of the way to approach this is that in the top directory you have a few command line utilities, and with XVM info, for instance, you could get lists of your configurations. So this is like a kind of a read-only user interface to see what you have configured in the MySQL. So it uses a MySQL database for configuration. And this then becomes your, so you basically have like one server where you set up Xtrabackup Manager, and it then will SSH, so you configure your other server names where you have MySQL databases running. If you use SSH into those, you need to have extra, currently, we are kind of discussing whether it would make sense to actually copy the extra backup binaries back and forth, but currently you need to have extra backup installed together with all MySQL servers. You need to also install the kind of SSH public key so you can log in automatically from Chrome without human interaction. And then it is currently set up such that it will stream, because extra backup has this stream function, which is great. So instead of backing up a file on the MySQL server where you are, it will stream it back in a kind of tar file stream, use netcap, and it will come back to this central server that extra backup manager is running. And then you have configured a directory with the save, and it will be saved kind of in a year, month, server name, something, directories. Okay, this is the basic operation. And what you end up with, and this is like extra backup feature. So what you end up with is basically a copy of the MySQL directory. So with some additional comments where it is applying the InnoDB logs, you end up with a clean MySQL database. So when you want to restore, this is just the directory, but this is like a MySQL data directory that you will copy somewhere and start the new MySQL server there and then you can restore your data. This is, by the way, a feature I like about extra backup compared to something like MySQL now. Actually taking the backup is also faster, but the nice thing is that the restore operation is very fast. It's just how much time it will take to copy your data over the network. Because it's in the restore phase where you really want to save time and make it as simple as possible.
Does it automatically apply the logs for you? Because extra backup doesn't, that's a separate step. And
yes, so this is like kind of something that extra backup manager would need to do. And I think currently there is just one class that can do full backups. But then that's kind of the thing, what you do with the backup manager also is to say that yeah, I actually want to do the full backup maybe between Saturday and Sunday during the night or whenever you have least traffic on the database, and then every day maybe I want to do an incremental backup against that. And this, so if you are using incremental backup, this also affects, you cannot do the last apply phase if you also want to do incremental backups. Or so this is maybe more about your religious beliefs. So I would like to always have a backup where everything has been applied, and I don't then need to have a crash and figure out that actually something is wrong with the apply. I would actually want to go further, so once they have been applied, I would want to also write some functionality that tries to read and verify that the data is actually not corrupt.
Okay.
So to do that, I will have to apply it so they can start MySQL server for test purposes on top of that. So then one approach could be to have this non-applied version so that you can take incremental backups against it. But then also always make sure that you have something where something has been applied and you have maybe done some tests against it to make sure that the data is there. Then you use double the amount of disk space if you do this. So there is no conclusion probably. There will be many classes that have different strategies. Or at least one class that can take parameters and do this or that to it. So currently what really works now, except that I kind of didn't prepare this talk in the sense that I would do a demo, so I don't actually have an extra backup in So there are actually three things when we talk about what is Xtrabackup Manager doing. So this backup strategy is one thing. I call it the strategies to say that I like my backup strategy to be full backup on the weekend and incremental backup every day. This is like one strategy. Or if you want a simple strategy, I just take a full backup once a week or once a day or all the time, whatever. If you have a small database, this is very simple. Okay. But this is the backup strategy. Also includes how like a kind of retention policy. So actually it makes sense to store more than just the most recent backup. So one way is to say, okay, I took a new backup, now I'm finished, I will delete the old backup. But often it makes sense to save maybe even very old backups. Maybe you want to save once a year backup from last year. Even in this cycle, maybe you want to save all of the incremental backups, and you have all the backups from last week, and maybe from the previous cycle, maybe three cycles is something that people feel comfortable about. It again depends how much data and disk space you have also. So all of this is managing these cycles goes into the topic of backup strategy, and currently we have one strategy which is just the full backup. From many remote servers. And then you could also support different backup methods. So now we are focused on extra backup. And if you happen to have, of course, these InnoDB hot backup licenses, you could pretty much use this with that just as well. But this kind of backup manager could of course use MySQL dump also as a method. So a lot of the work done here is like scheduling and what is the host name and how do I log in and where do I store the backup, and then actually using the extra backup binary is a relatively small part of that process. So you could just as well have another class that uses MySQL dump, and maybe in a very distant future you could backup other things than just MySQL database. Similarly. And then the third thing, which kind of overlaps a little bit with strategy, but it's a separate topic, is the scheduling. So scheduling, okay, you can say that my strategy is to take full backups and then some amount of incremental backups, but scheduling is actually say, okay, I want to do this on a weekly cycle. Between Saturday and Sunday first. Extra backup manager, this is kind of a Unix way of doing this. We already have crontab, so we don't re-implement crontab, but rather it just writes a crontab for you. And currently this is actually in the MySQL tables, it just saves the crontab stream. So if we actually had a user interface, maybe you would have some nice calendar widgets and then you would have hours or minutes separately. But the actual data that is saved is just the crontab stream. For this reason, if you want to install extra backup manager, you create a new user for it. So you create an extra backup manager Unix user that then can have its own crontab file and then use it exclusively. And this is done the crontab is created by the XBM flush command. So if you have configured the tables, this will read your configuration and create a contact file that will do what you expect it to do. And then from the cron file, it is actually using this XBM backup command. And this is the command that will log into the other servers and stream backups. Okay, so and this so the things I talked about here, like the comments that you see here work, except that they don't work in my installation because I've hacked something that broke it. Let's look at what the tables look like. That usually gives you a good idea. let's start with hosts. And like I said, so the best way now, if you want to try this, is to first create this MP table schema. And there is another SQL file with some example data, which you can use if you want. And then you can use this XBM conf tool, which will import and export CSV files for you. That's probably the... Or maybe, like most people using these are DBAs anyway, so I think you are just fine using the SQL. Okay, so you have a table with host information, what is the host name, and some information, when was the last backup. Doing is this kind of, you can turn on, off, is this active or not. So if a host is put into not active mode, then the task that is performing the backup will actually skip this. Okay. This is just a directory path, basically, on your server, on the Xtrabackup Manager server, and maybe it's then like mounting some large disk from disk server or something. And of course, eventually you probably record this tape, but in the sense of backing up data from MySQL, Xtrabackup Manager will just copy some directory and place it there, and then from there it's somebody else's responsibility to back up on the tape or offsite over the network. And then the third table. Actually, the kind of not the extra backup binary, but this wrapper script I talked about needs to connect to MySQL, so we need a MySQL user and password. And then you have kind of foreign keys to the configured host and configured backup volumes. Then there's also MySQL type ID. This is some extra backup anti feature where you have different binaries for different versions of MySQL, because like I told you, they're copied code from InnoDB. So this was an easy way for them maybe for each version of MySQL servers that have been released, they actually run a different version of Xtrabackup. So let's see, do I have even if it doesn't work, I probably have some example data around. So this is maybe easier to follow. Simple, just basically the host name is the important information here and the fact that it's active. Also backup volumes, I think I have one. Okay, I have two which were the same place. And then the scheduled backup. So here is where you actually see So to configure these three files, you could actually get this running. I would say more work is to make sure that you have SSH key correctly installed on all the other servers and extra backup installed on the other server. And then, sorry for not having a demo, but you can actually run this to take full backups. So that part worked quite early on. And then from here, it becomes more complex now. So like you said, so can you take incremental backups? And if you do, do you have my logs or not? And I would I would want to run some verifications even. And that's non-trivial. So it's kind of like you had to talk about
MK table checks on.
MK table checks on. That's used to check whether your master and slave are in sync or actually contain the same data. And this is I think Baron's solution there is quite genius. Mm-hmm. I haven't figured out if that can be applied here. But here we have the same problem. So we have a server that is getting updates. And then if I take a backup, I can just compare the backup and the server because the server has already changed. So I don't know really what I'm going to do there. It's an interesting problem.
So why work on a new tool instead of the existing tools that are there, like Zmanda has a backup, and I have a recovery manager too, where you can say go to a point in time, and they have like a centralized web interface, and that's in the 4Pay product. I mean, we use the free product.
So I only recently heard that there actually is a free version.
Yeah, and it does everything. I mean, basically the free version is everything minus the GUI. The only thing that yours does that it doesn't is it doesn't make the cron tabs for you. But I'm certain you could write a script to do, to easily do that. And they just use a config file, so you don't need a database on your centralized backup server.
Yes. So actually, I will be looking into Zmanda.
Okay.
Because I had always thought it was just which you could still. I know actually what it does, even though I never used it myself. And it actually, especially like when you want to also copy the binary logs and have point in time recovery. This starts to become non-trivial.
Yeah, but they've done it.
Yes.
That's why I'm like, why reinvent the wheel? And what they do is they just copy the binary logs, and so you can apply logs or not. It doesn't apply the incrementals to the backup. So when you restore, you still have to restore, apply logs. But that's where you can come in handy, I think.
I can rather change that.
Exactly. So this is good.
The other thing I hadn't realized for me, Zmanda, because you used to use Zmanda kind of as a front end to do LVM snapshots.
Right.
So I had actually.
You thought it was only.
In my mind, this was an alternative to InnoDB hot backup. So then when extra backup came along, somehow I didn't realize that, of course, Zmanda can also support extra backup.
Right. It's like you were saying with the classes of you can also support this. And they already do it, and it already works. So
yes. So, all of this I kind of realized a week ago.
Oh, okay. Well, if you need help getting in touch with people, I know some of the guys there. So
good. And we'll probably be looking into that. So yes.
I mean, you probably know. I know it's free. I don't know if it's open source, but I certainly know they'd be willing to get help from the community. So
there is like a community version. And
yeah, like I said, it's free, but I don't know if it's open source. There's a difference, right?
I will look into that.
But yeah, I know they've worked with Percona on extra backup to make their premium product better. Like they were supposed to have an announcement at the MySQL conference. Maybe they didn't.
And this is like even if there was no free or open source version,
I
think backup is one of the areas where you can actually pay for a tool if it's good and reliable.
Right.
So this is just something I was looking into.
Yeah.
It's very early. The good thing is that I think the approach is right and the code quality is good. So this is perhaps at the moment more if this is PHP instead of C++. So if you want the MySQL related project to actually work on, rather than having a solution that already works, then this is more in that area at the moment.
And maybe you can reuse some of the code. to the for the other project, so.
Yeah, I doubt the semantics PHP.
Well, you can reuse the algorithms anyway.
Yeah.
The ideas.
Yes. So that, but that's pretty much the situation with Xtrabackup Manager. Since we are in Europe and Lachlan is in California, I thought I'd give a talk about it because it's a new project. And this is the state. And by the way, thanks for bringing up Samantha, because it's certainly incredible.
I figured you probably didn't know about it, or you know, and it's not really a fair question because Lachlan maybe didn't know about it, you know. So, but it seemed like you're doing a lot of work when you could better use that time to modify what's
yes.
there. And of course, if it's not open source and they don't want it to be, then you know, certainly there's a reason.
Yes.
But if
yeah,
not,
so I knew not. So first of all, I didn't knew that it worked with Xtrabackup at all.
Right.
Nor that it was open source. So, but it might be both, so then it's kind of doing all of this without...
Yeah, it definitely works with Xtrabackup, and one of the nicer things, too, is that you can say, if it doesn't work with Xtrabackup, then use LVM Snapshot. If it doesn't work with that, then use MySQL Dump.
Yeah.
So...
Yeah, so the original idea was, what this was that, yeah, okay, now we want to use Xtrabackup. And I completely realized that Samantha all the time was supporting many different
yeah.
utilities and methods.
And
of course, they also support Xtrabackup.
Yeah, it's technically a recovery manager, they call it, because it's more for recovery than for backup, because they don't have like the schedule or whatever, but that's not, I'm sure you can add that to it. It wouldn't be too hard. But you know, you can say, oh, I want to recover to this point in time, go, and it picks the right backup, and it does the copy, and it will copy to the right place, and it will start things, and it will apply logs, so it does it all, and then applies the binary logs too. So
yeah, the point-in-time recovery is cool. I've seen, I mean, we sold this product in my scale time, so I've seen the presentations, I just never used it myself. And so it's like when you do undo in a word processor or something that just throws all the scale state and say, I want to recover to this point, right before you drop the table state, and then it will play it for you. I thought that was cool when they first did it. And that's, having a user interface like that is certainly non-trivial. Yeah. Okay.